Scene 1A, take 2.
Scene 5B, take 3. Scene 7B, take 1. This is Room Tone in the Blanket Fort. Scene 7A, take 2. Scene 5D, take 4.
Scene 1B,
I'm ready.
Sounds ready.
Another early morning. Change your clothes, grab your stuff, get on the train. Don't be late. I don't believe a lot of people think about the amount of work that goes into capturing the sound for a film. Everybody's too focused on the visuals.
Change that light. Readjust the frame.
Let's go for another rehearsal. No, I don't want a ComTech, and can this be MOS? But at the end of the day, which would you rather lose? Your ability to see or your ability to hear? I'd take this. Maybe that's just me. But the importance of sound in filmmaking is tremendous, and although it should be treated as such, it just isn't most of the time. People generally think about it last, or consider it a fix-it-in-post position. But I'll tell ya, it's a lot more work to fix something in post than to do a great job on production. And I would know because I've done both. I think what attracted me to pursue sound for film is its ability to change an average film into a professional level one. It's that important. If the sound is noticeable, it's bad. And that's why we work so hard to do something that most other departments never do. We try to be invisible. To those of you who reach out early for a sound mixer, thank you. I know some may not consider production sound a craft, but it most certainly is, especially in my heart. You tell a story with words and pictures, so make sure you get somebody to capture those words just as good as the pictures.